Hey everyone, Papa PC is back. After such a hit on the CL30 versus CL36 short and so many questions, I had to make something much more detailed. Stay until the end. This is going to be epic. So, big topic today. RAM timing and smoothness. With DDR5 prices going absolutely nuts since October 2025, we're not just talking about performance. We're talking about ROI. Why? Well, AI data centers have been chewing through DDR5 like crazy. Samsung, SK Hynix, Micron, they're all selling their highest volume chips straight to AI integrators. Consumer kits? Well, we're getting the leftovers. CL36 is 30% up and counting. CL30 has basically tripled. And CL26 or CL28, premium tier, may as well be the new gold. And just talking about 32 gigs here. For 64 gigabytes, it costs now more than a PS5. So today, we're testing 5 different DDR5 kits. CL40, CL36, CL30, CL28 and CL26. And not only looking at average FPS, but also at 1% lows and 0.1% lows to really understand how latency affects gameplay. We're doing this on Ryzen 7 9700X, the Ryzen 7 9800X3D paired with the RTX 5060 Ti, 5070 Ti and 5080. Resolutions tested 1080p, 1440p and 4K. Let's get into it. To understand why we're measuring 1% lows and 0.1% lows, you need to understand frame time versus FPS. FPS, frames per second, is just an average. How many frames you render over time? But high average FPS doesn't necessarily equal a smooth experience if your frame delivery is erratic. Frame time is how long it takes to render each frame, measured in milliseconds. Irregular frame times, some very low, some very high, lead to stutters, even when your average FPS looks great. That's where 1% lows and 0.1% lows come in. The 1% low is the average of the worst 1% of frames. It represents sustained, frequent dips. The 0.1% low is even more severe. The worst 0.1% of frames, often the very brief, jacked stutters that can feel like micro freezes. If you have a high average FPS but your 1% lows or 0.1% lows are very low, you'll experience stuttering, hitching or jank, even if your FPS counter looks great. Getting those lows closer to your average FPS is what makes a game feel fluid, not just fast. So, the testing was done in these three titles known to hammer CPUs: Cyberpunk 2077, Starfield, and Shadow of the Tomb Raider. Let's start with 1080p, where RAM latency matters the most. Quick explanation regarding the charts. The 9700X will be always on the front side, while the X3D will be always on the back side. On 1080p, with the RTX 5060 Ti, the 9700X reacts really strongly to RAM latency. CL40 is the slowest. You get a clear jump going to CL36 and an even bigger one at CL30. CL28 and CL26 push the lows even further. On the 9800X3D, the differences flatten out. Average FPS barely changes across the CL values, but the 1% lows and 0.1% lows still get smoother with the CL26. With the RTX 5070 Ti, the pattern is similar. On the 9700X, lower latency brings solid gains, especially at CL30 and CL26. On the X3D, average FPS barely scales, but tighter timings still help smooth out the 1% and 0.1% lows. With the RTX 5080, both CPUs get pushed harder. The 9700X still shows improvements going from CL40 down to CL26, but the gap between CL30 and CL26 gets much smaller. The 9800XVD flattens even more. Average FPS barely changes, though the 1% lows and 0.1% lows are still slightly cleaner with tighter RAM. This means going from CL40 to CL26 doesn't just boost your average FPS. It dramatically reduces micro-stutters thanks to much stronger 0.1 lows. At 1440p, the differences shrink across all GPUs. On the 9700X, CL30 is still a good bump over CL40, and CL26 adds a bit more but nowhere near what we saw at 1080p. On the 9800XVD, the scaling is even tighter. You still get slightly better 1% lows and smoother 0.1% lows with CL30 and CL26, but the impact is much smaller. At 4K, the GPU takes over. Average FPS barely changes, with docking under 1% to 2% between CL40 and CL26. 1% lows barely move, and even the 0.1% lows stay mostly the same. At 4K, RAM latency simply doesn't matter anymore, your GPU is the bottleneck. With all the charts side by side, the CPU behavior is crystal clear. On the 9700X, RAM latency makes a huge difference, both in average FPS and especially in 1% and 0.1% lows, mainly at 1080p. On the 9800X3D, average FPS barely changes with RAM timing, but you still get noticeably smoother frame pacing with CL30 and CL26. So the takeaway is simple. 9700X low latency RAM gives real FPS gains. 9800X3D low latency RAM improves smoothness, not peak FPS. So, after all that testing, here's how the kits stack up. CL26, so the G-Skill Triton Z5, best for lows and micro-stutter, but very expensive right now. CL28, the Corsair Vengeance, RGB, very close to CL26 in lows, better value than CL26 if you can find it. CL30, another Corsair Vengeance, RGB, the best balance, big improvement over CL36 and CL40, good lows and decent price to performance. CL36, Corsair Vengeance RGB, mid-tier latency but price has gone up and counting. CL40, the Corsair Vengeance non-RGB here, slowest but ironically now costs as much as CL36 used to. So what's the play in 2025 with this RAM market going crazy? Here's the clean breakdown. Best price performance, CL36. Don't overpay for CL30 right now. Best gaming smoothness, CL30. Especially on 9700X, 1080p or high FPS esports, for example. Minimal gains for huge costs, CL26 and CL28. Only worth it if you want the absolute best frame pacing. For 9800X3D users, you can run CL40 without losing much, but CL30 still improves stutters. For 4K gamers, RAM timing barely matters. Focus on cashing on a good GPU and its VRAM. My advice is to really scan the market. You can still make good deals, but stocks are running low, and you can already see some opportunists buying kits of RAM they don't need, for we sell them at double the price straight away on Marketplace, eBay or any second-hand market. For 4K, latency becomes irrelevant. Don't bother spending more for tight timings. For 9800XVD or other 3D cache CPUs, lowering latency improves smoothness, 1% and 0.1% lows, more than peak FPS. CL30 is still a smart buy, CL26 is overkill for most. Given the current price crisis, prioritize performance per dollar. If RAM is twice as expensive as before, every timing choice matters more. With RAM prices exploding this fall due to AI demand, be smart. The days of cheap RAM kits are gone for now and possibly for the years to come. It was Papa PC. I hope you enjoyed this video. Like, share, and subscribe for more. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.